This ice is 20,000 years old, and it came from here in Antarctica. We're a group of 15 PhD students working in ice core science, and in this video series, we'll attempt to answer these questions. In this video, I will introduce you to the science of ice cores, and as I'm talking, links to other videos will pop up if you want to learn more about each topic. Every year, snow falls onto the Antarctic ice sheet, forming an annual layer. These layers are compressed over time by the weight of new snow above. This pushes older ice deeper and deeper. By extracting an ice column, we effectively get a cross-section of the layers. This column is called an ice core. Many of its properties depend on the climate when the snow fell. Therefore, the ice core is a climate archive, where the surface is the present and the deepest part is far in the past. The uppermost part of an ice core is called the fern. This is where the snowflakes turn into solid ice, the structure of which can be very different depending on the temperature and pressure conditions it experiences. When we look closely at the water molecules, we can see that some are lighter and some are heavier. The proportions of these can tell us about the air temperature when the ice formed. As the ice forms, bubbles of air get trapped inside. These bubbles of ancient air capture how the Earth's atmosphere has changed over time. We also find dust. This can be soil blown from other continents or ash from an erupting volcano landing on the surface snow, which became trapped in the ice. At the base of the ice sheet, debris and gases contained within give us a window into the type of ecosystems and environmental conditions that existed during the Earth's ice-free periods. With all of this information from ice cores, we can understand how the climate has changed in the past, and then use computer models to predict the climate of the future. I'm part of DEEPICE because it allows me to work with an international group of scientists trying to understand the climate.